Welcome back to the Livin' La Vida Low Carb Show with Jimmy Moore. And today we have a very special edition of the Livin' La Vida Low Carb Show because we have with us a gentleman who has done some research. He is all the way from Belgium, and he did some research on various categories of gut microbiota that is out there. His name is Jeroen Jas, and he is from the Flemish Institute for Biotechnology in Belgium. And he's done some really fascinating work. The brand new study just came out on April the 20th, 2011. I'm going to have him tell a little more about what the study was, what he was actually looking for, and what the conclusions were. Jeroen, welcome to the show.
Hi, great to be there.
Well, tell us more about your work. What was the conclusion of this study that you've been doing for quite a long time?
Yeah, it was over 2 years of work. So what we did was we looked at the gut flora, so the bacteria that live in your intestine, of over 200 individuals in I think more than 10 different countries. Mm-hmm. And we tried to compare those. So we have new techniques using DNA sequencing to investigate the genes and the genetic material in our flora. And by comparing the different flora of all the different individuals, we saw that there were three main gut types, which is very surprising to us because we didn't really expect that. So you can think of this like something like your blood type, right?
Right.
So apparently in the population, there are three types of gut flora.
And what are those three?
And so we can classify these three based on their species composition. What I mean is that you have the different types of bacteria, different species of bacteria that live in your gut. And there's one type which we call the Bacteroidetes type, which is a certain type of bacteria which dominates that constellation. Then there's the other type which we call the Prevotella, which is another name of a bacteria. And there's another one we call the Ruminococcus type. And you can think of this as sort of, ecosystem optima. Now, this is a very complicated way of thinking, but your gut is an ecosystem, right? These bacteria are living and growing there, and these, your gut flora can have all types of constellations. Sometimes this bacteria is more dominant, sometimes this bacteria is more dominant. And especially in terms of when you have an infection, for example, these infectious bacteria become dominant, and then you have problems. Now, here we weren't looking at infections, but we were looking at the natural, healthy flora. And we see that in each of these three types, you have a different mix of bacteria in your gut flora. And what we also saw is that these bacteria have different properties. And so what we think now is that each of these different types might be able to digest your food in a different way. These bacteria, they don't all eat the same things, right? And so we think that one of the types would be better at degrading protein and things like that, while another type would be less good at that.
Right.
But of course, these are very, very early observations, and we can't say too much about it, but it has very important consequences.
So because is genetics playing a role in this, that
no.
People are born with this, or does it just develop over time? How does that work?
So this is a very good question. So the way you get your gut flora is actually contamination, right? And when a baby is born, he's born sterile, and he gets the flora by contact with his mother in the birth process, by breastfeeding, by whatever babies put in their mouth. They get bits and pieces, various bacteria in their gut flora. And during the first year of a baby's year, the flora is very unstable. It goes in all directions. It is very, this ecosystem is still forming, right?
Yeah.
But as soon as babies start eating solids, the flora becomes really stable. And so what we don't know yet about these types is whether they are stable in time, and that you have this type your whole life long, or whether you can switch from one type to another. That is still something we have to investigate. And this could be very interesting, of course, because if it is like a more of a state than a type, and there might be good and bad types, you could actually switch from one type to another, become ill, and maybe in the other way around, by changing your diet, you could move back to your original type.
Yeah, I was going to ask you what role diet plays in this formation of the different types that you could be in.
Yeah, this is something we don't know very much yet. So what we do know is that if we cluster these people from very different countries, so for example, there's Japanese and Americans and Europeans who do have quite different food habits. In this study, we see that these clusters together. So we have a type in which we find Japanese people and American people and European people. Now, this doesn't mean that the nutrition doesn't play a role, because these are all Western diets anyway.
Right.
And maybe it's not the fact that you eat, sushi-derived protein or hamburger-derived protein, but just that you eat a certain amount of protein, right? But these are things we don't know yet. So deep down, I still think there's a food component there, but at the moment we don't have much evidence for that yet.
So have you examined any role that a specific macronutrient would have on the formulation of these various gut flora, like carbohydrate? Does it stimulate a certain kind, whereas protein stimulates maybe another kind? Or is there any conclusions about that yet?
In this particular study, no. There are studies out there which have shown this. People are doing experiments, for example, in mice where they can control the diet very well, and there they do see an effect of nutrition on the flora. So if you give mice high carb or low carb or high protein or low protein diet, this does alter the flora. And now we have to start reconciling these observations with the observations of these three gut types to see whether we can link all these things up.
So what are the health ramifications of the various kinds of bacteria that are in the stomach? Because a lot of people listening will be like, yeah, it doesn't matter that there's different kinds. What does that mean to me? Is there any risks involved with having one kind of bacteria over another?
So specific kinds of bacteria, there's lots of clear-cut cases there. Mm-hmm. We know certain bacteria that are responsible for certain diseases. Now, that is the link between disease and these gut types. That is, I'm very sorry, but this is how science is. That is something we are investigating right now. We are investigating various diseases, and we already seen links between certain types and certain diseases. But this is something you'll have to come back later for. But I really think that the flora has an enormous impact on our human body. You must not forget that the flora is in terms of weight, it's an organ at the size of your brain, right? And the number of bacterial cells is 10 times the number of human cells in your body. So you're carrying around a gigantic load of bacteria, which are incredibly important for our well-being. For me, it's obvious that the composition of your flora has an effect on your health. But this is early days. This field is just at the moment it's basically exploding because of all these novel DNA sequencing technologies. Everybody's is investigating these things, and you see one discovery after another. Talk to me again in a year or so, and I'll be able to tell you much, much more.
Well, we'll certainly do that. His name is Yarun Yaz, and if you want to check out his study, gut microbiota, all the three different types that they've identified, that they're not related to any race, native country, or diet, you can learn more about this metagenomics study in the, Nature Science Journal?
Nature.
And it was published on April the 20th, 2011, and of course, metagenomics, that's hard to say, is the study of the genetic material of complete ecosystems, otherwise known as the human gut in this case. Well, Yarun Yaz, thanks so much for joining us here today on the Livin' La Vida Low Carb Show and explaining more about your study. And something tells me we'll hear more from you in the future.
Well, thank you for your interest.